Very good morning, students. Children, in the last class, we had completed our English prose portion. Now, today onwards, we are going to start our grammar portion, that is figures of speech. Okay, now you must all be thinking the figures of speech already we had done. Yes, children, in the first semester, we had done two figures of speech, that is simile and alliteration. Okay. So, children, let me clear it that in 6th standard, that means this year, you will be learning the 5 types of figures of speech. There are many types of figures of speech, but children, in 6th standard, only you will going to learn the 5 types of figures of speech. And when you will go in 7th standard, children, so you will be learn more those 10 figures of speech above. Okay? So, let us start figures of speech. Okay, but then to children, I'm starting again with simile and alliteration just for as a revised portion. Okay, and one more thing, children, I'm sending you as a PDF in the next week of this chapter. But all those notes, whatever I have given in the PDF, that all those notes you have to copy down in your grammar notebook. Okay, so let's start our topic, figures of speech. Okay, now can you tell me, children, what are figures of speech? Yes, figures of speech make up a huge portion of the English language, making it more creative, more expressive, and just for interesting. A figure of speech is one of the poetic devices used in a poem to make the language more effective and beautiful. So, children, why figures of speech we use? Because it makes the sentence more interesting. A language, English language, it makes a sentence more creative and expressive. When we read, for example, if we read a story, can you see there are many sentences? These are repeated. Some are compared with the objects. That means like that many sentences we see even in the poet, even in the prose part. So that's why we used the figures of speech. So, children, why do we use figures of speech? A figures of speech is one of the poetic devices used in a poem to make the language more effective and beautiful. Okay? Now, let us see the types of figures of speech. The first one is simile. Second, alliteration. Third one, personification. Fourth, repetition. And fifth, metaphor. I repeat again, children. First, simile. Second, alliteration. Three, personification. Four, repetition. And five, metaphor. Okay? But simile and alliteration, then too we have done. But still, we are going to do see again that what is simile and alliteration. Okay, children? Because in examination, it is going to become identify the figures of speech. Okay, now let us see first that what is simile. The word simile means likeness. A simile is a comparison between two different things which have something in common. A simile always has the words as or like. So children, simile means when we compare two different things by saying one thing is like the other. So now if I comparing one to another, but while doing this, children, I'm using the word as or like. Only two words, as or like. So children, when we see in a sentence the words which are root as or like, so just write, think that the word is simile. Okay, now here are some few examples are given. First one, as cute as a kitten. Now, can you see in a sentence as word is given? Yes, as cute as a kitten. Now, here it has described, compare about the cuteness of a kitten. He is cute. Who, children? A kitten. So, that means as cute as a kitten. So, here as is a simile. Okay, now we will see one more example. She had a face as lovely as a flower. Now, we again, we can see the word, it has compared the lovely and flowers, the face, lovely and flowers, by the word added over here, as. So, she had a face as lovely as a flower. So here's a comparison between two different things which have something in common, but the words which I'd use as a simile is as. Now one more example, the third one. The angry man roared like a bull. Okay, now angry man roared. Now here's a comparison between the two different things. The angry man roared. How did he roar? Like a bull. So your like is a simile. So whenever we see in a sentence the word as or like, those sentences are called as a simile. Okay, children? So again I'm repeating. A simile is a comparison between two different things which have something in common is called as a simile. And simile always has the words as or like. Okay, children? Now let's see the second figure of speech, that is alliteration. Now many students get confused. That means alliteration and repetition both are same. So let me tell you children, no, they both are different. So let's see the what are the difference of alliteration and repetitions are there. Okay, now we will see that second figure of speech, that is alliteration. When the same sound, a letter, occurs at the beginning of two or more words in the same line, the figure of speech is alliteration. So children, what is the meaning of alliteration? In alliterations, we had a specific repetition of sound beginning of the one letter, that is called as a alliteration. Now there are some few examples of alliteration. Peter Piper picked a pack of picked peppers. Now over here, can you see the repetition of a one letter, children? One alphabet? Yes. In every sentence, words, the P, the beginning letter P is repeated. Peter P, Piper P, picked P, peck P, picked P, and pepper P. So alliteration has a specific, the repetition of the sound. It is the beginning of the sound of the word. Second one, Tim's turtle tumbles. Okay, now can you tell me which word is repeated over here, children? The letter, the beginning of the word? Yes, the letter T is repeated. That means the repetition of the sound T. Third one, six swans went swimming in the sea. Now one more, can you tell me children that which sound is repeated in the sentence, in a word? Yes, six S, swan S, swimming S, and C S. So here the repetition of the sound S. So children, what is the meaning of alliteration? Alliteration, it means the same sound or letters occurs at the beginning of two or more words. Listen it very carefully, children, that beginning of two or more words, okay, and in the same line, so that is called as an alliteration. Not at the second letter, it should be at the beginning of the letter, that is words that in the same line, okay, that is called as an alliteration. Now we will see what is personification. Now third, personification. Personification is a figure of speech used in the poem where inanimate objects are given human qualities. Inanimate object means, children, the non-living thing are given as a human qualities. It means for any non-human things, if I give any kind of human quality, hence that is called as a personification. Okay? Oh, now just look at the example, children. The flower danced in the wind. Okay, now can you tell me, children, flower can able to dance? Now look at the particular flowers, it's dancing. But generally who dance, children? Yes, we human being. Right. So here the activity is done by the human. So not by the flower. So your danced is an personification. Second one. Time flies and wait for no one. Okay, now can you tell me, children, at the particular word flies, but generally, children, who flies? Time, is it times fly? No, generally who flies? The birds, isn't it? So here, the birds. So children, can you tell me, have you seen alarm clock flying ever? No, not at all. But it just is the imagination. So why are we doing all this thing? The reason is when we do all the things, the kind of sentence, it creates a strong picture in the reader's mind. So means in our mind. Okay, now let us give you one more example, children. The clock screams in my ear. Now over here, can you tell me, children, look at the particular word screams. Now generally, who screams? Yeah, we as a human being. Have you ever seen the clock screams in your ear? No, it's just an imagination. So it has given the qualities, given the human qualities of inanimate objects. So it is called as a personification. Okay, so what is meaning by personification, children? Personification is a figure of speech used in the poem where inanimate objects are given the human qualities, and it has added effectiveness to the human qualities, and it has added to the beauty of the poem. That is called as a personification. So personification means giving a human quality to non-living things. It is called as a personification. I hope it is clear to you, children, what is personification. Okay, now we will next move to a fourth figures of speech, that is repetition. Now what is repetition? Now be clear, children, the alliteration is different and repetition is different. In alliterations, only the first beginning letter of the sound is repeated. Okay, now repetitions, let's see. Repetition words, lines and phrases over again to stress the importance of the idea. So repetition means that repeats the words, lines and phrases over again. Why? To stress the importance of the idea. That means we repeat the same word or phrases maybe twice or thrice time. But why could we do that, children? The reason, get the idea or to clarify the idea. Okay. Now here are some examples are given of repetition. The first one, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Now can you tell me which is the word is repeated over here, children? Yes, the word snow, 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 it's repeated thrice time, isn't it, children? So that is the reason it is called a repetition. I repeat again, student, the words which is repeated either twice or thrice time, it is called as a repetition. Now one more sentence. The president said, work, work and work are the keys to success. Now can you tell me which is the word is repeated over your children? Yes, the word work, work, work. Is it repeated twice or thrice time? Yes, it is repeated thrice time. Either in a sentence twice, either in a sentence thrice time. If the word is repeated again and again, it is called as a repetition. Okay, children. Now one more example I had given you. Spring is flowers, spring is green grass, spring is rainy days. Now spring words is repeated again over here in the sentence the thrice time. So here the word is repetitions. So I hope you must have clear that what is alliteration and what is repetition. One more time I am repeating. Alliteration, the beginning letters of the words which is repeated in the sentence, and repetition means the words which is repeated again and again. So there is a difference between letter and word. Okay, children. Now our last figure of speech, that is metaphor. Metaphor means it describes an object or action in a way that isn't literally true but helps to explain an idea to make a comparison. So it's very easy metaphor to identify the sentence of metaphor sentence. It means, so children, how do we recognize this kind of sentences? It is very easy to recognize metaphor. The reason is that a way of comparing two things in a very interesting way and exciting. So now do this. Generally, what happens? We describe an object, an action. So by going a task low or giving comparison. So that means the objects or actions are given, but we doesn't know it's a metaphor. It's just literally the true to compare the idea. It is called as a metaphor. For example, it's raining cats and dog. Now here, so it's raining cats and dog. Can cats and dog rain? No, cats and dog can fall. So the exact sentence will be, it is raining very heavily. Okay, now one more example. Life is a roller coaster. Okay, now can you tell me, you know, life is a roller coaster? No, life is a full of ups and down. It's not a roller coaster. So it is just as compared to make a literal true sentence. So this sentence, it's called as a metaphor. So children, life is a roller coaster. It does not mean that the life is a roller coaster, but it means that life have lots of ups and downs. So here it is compared with the roller coaster. Okay, so the one more example I'm just saying you, the classroom was a zoo. Now here the classroom has compared with the zoo, but that means the classroom is completely mess. So over here we have comparing the classroom with a zoo. So that means to compare a word from another action, that is called as a metaphor. And one more thing, children, remember, metaphors are unique because they compare the things without using like and as. So in the sentence where like and as are not there, but it is compared with the object or action, that sentence is called as a metaphor. But if in a sentence it is compared with two words, as or like, so those sentences are called as a simile. So don't get confused in simile and metaphor. Okay, children, I hope you almost have understood that all five figures of speech. Okay, let me just tell you in short again what is the types of figures of speech. So we have learned today the five types of figures of speech. The first one is simile. Simile means, children, the word simile means likeness. A simile is a comparison between two different things which have something in common. A simile always has the word as or like. Second one we had seen, alliteration. Alliteration means when the same sound or letter occurs at the beginning of two or more words in the same line, the figure of speech is alliteration. Next one is personification. This is a third figure of speech. Personification is a figure of speech used in the poem where inanimate object means, children, the non-living thing objects are given to the human qualities. A fourth figure of speech is repetition. Repetition, words, lines and phrases over again to stress the importance of the idea. And the last figure of speech is metaphor. Metaphor, it describes an object or action in a way that isn't literally true. That means that sentence has been described with an object and action, but it doesn't have literally the true meaning, but helps to explain an idea to make a comparison. So those sentences are called as a metaphor. Okay, children, in the next class, I will be sending you the PDF file of this chapter.